Made possible by the McCormick Tribune Foundation, the Madeline and Richard Halpern Gift Fund, and by the Ethics and Excellence in Journalism Foundation. Tonight's program originates from the Gary K. Marshall Studio in Evanston.
Coming up on the Northwestern News Report, two aldermanic races pit a former alderman against the current one,
and several other candidates are using YouTube to reach out to younger voters.
From the Medill School of Journalism and the City Colleges of Chicago, this is the Northwestern News Report.
There's a lot to keep track of in Chicago's 50 wards this election season. Lydia Few talks with a local political writer about hot topics in the aldermanic races.
I'm here with staff political writer for Chicagoist.com, Kevin Robinson. Thanks for joining us.
Hi.
So obviously we want to talk about the aldermanic races. What do you think the top ones are?
I think I'd have to look at the 25th ward. You've got the alderman, Danny Solis, who was appointed by Daley after Ambrosio Medrano went to prison in the Silver Shovel scandal. He got out of prison and he's running now for re-election. The race there is part of a larger power struggle within the Mexican community for, you know, who's going to have their hands on the piggy bank at the end of the day.
Both talked about gentrification in that area. Can you just talk a little bit about that as an issue?
You know, you go out into the underdeveloped wards, in general places on the south side or the west side, where people want gentrification. They want to see more people move into the neighborhood, fix up the area. And then you get into places where it's actually happened. The 32nd ward is a great example of that, where gentrification's happened at such a rapid pace and at such a large scale that the community almost can't stand it anymore. So it's sort of the perennial issue, and it's something that a lot of communities are in conflict with, trying to find a balance.
What kind of a role does labor play in these aldermanic races this year?
This is probably the most active that the labor movement in Chicago has been on the ground, in particular in an aldermanic race. They've picked several different wards where they're targeting aldermen, you know, to take them out. So they're putting money into campaigns, they're putting people on the ground to knock on doors and turn out the vote, and they're talking to their membership.
What are the issues that you think Chicagoans will be voting on the most?
Did their aldermen support the big box ordinance? What's he doing with TIF funds? You know, but at the same time, a lot of people are voting on basic aldermanic issues. You know, it's been said that being an alderman in Chicago means being a custodian to the ward. If you look at the 32nd ward, Scott Waguespack versus Ted Matlak, the base of people in that ward are mad at Ted Matlak because he hasn't returned their phone calls. He doesn't get garbage trucks out. He doesn't plow the streets. You know, any serious student of Chicago history knows that, you know, not getting the streets plowed loses elections.
Do you expect significant turnover this election? Do you think voters are looking for a change?
Yeah, I think that there's going to be some turnover. I don't think that Daley's going to lose his strength in the council, but I think the forces that are aligned against him are going to gain some power in the council. What happens over the next term is going to make a big difference in what happens in the next election. If those forces that are aligned against Daley are able to make progress, then I think that they're going to have a better shot in the next election.
There are a fair number of candidates involved in scrapes with the law, et cetera. Could you just comment on how much effect that has on voters?
With the exception of Arinda Troutman, I'm not sure that it has that much of an effect on voters. I think that people pretty much expect it. You have to do something pretty outrageous to get voters mad at you in Chicago. So, you know, no big contracts, giving jobs to your friends. It's just par for the course.
Kevin Robinson, thanks so much for joining us. In the Chicago newsroom, I'm Lydia Thieu.